Gifted and talented children can be defined as those with outstanding abilities developed at a level significantly ahead of their peers. These children require differentiated educational programs beyond those normally provided by the regular school program in order to realize their contribution to self and society. I caught up with 5-year-old Elias Mudomi, whose interest and understanding of aviation is remarkable, not just for a child, but even your normal adult. Sadly, the country lacks a clear policy on identification and placement of such children. Tonight, I look at Kenya's lack of infrastructure of nurturing and deploying such children in their respective gifted areas.
Hi, everybody. My name is Elias Mudomi Gitonga. I am 5 years old. I love airplanes very much and I want to become an aeronautical engineer. Okay. This is Augusta.
Where is it made?
It's made in Italy. This is the tail rotor. This is the main rotor. This is the horizontal stabilizer, vertical stabilizer is here. The nose is here. Cockpit is inside here. These are the windows. Somewhere here is the fuselage. These are the wheels.
His passion for aviation is admirable.
This plane, we got it from Commander Ogola in Kenya Air Force. He took me on a Bell Yuhi. We went to Zika. Then we landed somewhere, we turned around, then we went back to the airport.
And what did Captain Ogola tell you? What did you learn about planes from him? What did you learn from him?
What did even Captain Mutua was there?
And what did they teach you?
About a plane. What did they teach me? They taught me parts of a plane.
Like this one, what parts did you learn about this plane?
About?
This one. And what is it called?
The F-17 Zander.
At the age of 1, his parents noticed his mental ability was way beyond his age.
God said to them, you can eat everything you find here. But there is one special tree.
We noticed he could easily read words that were appearing on TV, especially during news time. So, and he had not done any formal learning, so he could just like relate when he sees the wording during news. So he could read by himself. But later when we tested with other things like now newspapers or magazines, he could comfortably read. So by the time he was 2 years, he was reading quite well.
What was unique about him, he never have that interaction with other kids. If you never impressed him with other children, you could see he's like a part. He's not mingling a lot with them. And that could make me I like to understand more why is the reason. But when I give him something like tablet, I give him something like, for example, an app of alphabet. You can see now he's trying to follow the dot.
Gifted children are very inquisitive and will ask questions beyond their age.
The first time we noticed he's so passionate in planes, he found me one time doing our website. And I'd open an image of a plane. So he was pointing. He kept on pointing that. So I told him the name of that plane. It was called Antonov plane. Then we had him repeat that the following day. So now we had to, like, when planes fly past, you could tell him now those are the actual planes. Those are the ones, the images that you see. So that continued growing. That passion continued growing so much that himself and I could go to the internet, just check the planes and comes and tells us that I need a Cessna. Can you buy me a Cessna? So because we don't know what is a Cessna, we have to go check online, get the image, go and look for a toy, such things.
Special needs education experts say that parents of children with exceptional abilities have tremendous responsibility.
It has been one of the most challenging moments of his upbringing, because when we enrolled him to a normal school that is doing CBC, but he was placed in the baby class, he was placed with his age mates, and it's fine. We didn't have an issue with the placement because socially he needs to be a baby. But now, academically, or these other areas, is far advanced. So we requested for an hybrid, where they are able to manage academics at his stage, but socially they manage him as a baby. But we find challenges a lot because the school also did not, there is no standard policy that the school can follow, which tells them, for example, that accelerated should be done this way. Should he stay with the same student in the same class? They are learning the alphabets or ABC, and Amy is already reading, paragraphs.
Check compression, combustion, exhaust.
You are taking off now? Yeah. When you are pulling it like this, you are taking off.
A lot of awareness needs to be created so that parents are able to identify and support these children early enough. There are currently no special schools for the intellectually gifted in the country.
We are hoping that with the new commission or the new department in the Ministry of Education that is going to implement the competence-based curriculum, we are going to move forward and establish, because as a nation, 58 years independent, and we have lost so many people because some of them go to other countries, they are recognized, and we know that even when we are talking to some people from outside, they have special jobs, they have been recognized, and we could be using them in our country.
The forces of a plane is lift, thrust, drag, weight.
While the Kenya Institute of Special Education is mandated to train teachers, the gap in the identification of these learners still remains a challenge.
Tell me about this one. This is nice. Do you want to give it to me?
I can.
You can give me. Mm. And then I return it or I keep it?
You keep it.
Really? You're too kind.
There is hope, so these parents should not be so frustrated that what am I going to do? Because schools in Kenya, private schools, which probably will take care of that child, they are very expensive, I can't afford. Government schools, they don't have the same programs, or they are overpopulated and they cannot be taken care of. So as studies of Maisha, I think one of the things we were trying to advocate for policy issues, how can the policy be looked at and then we're able to now bring this thing into schools.
This is a F-16Z fighter. Mm-hmm. It is made in America.
Over 30 countries worldwide have clear policies around special needs education for the gifted and talented. The same is yet to be applied in Kenya.
We must remember that this child is a child. If they are 5 years old, 6 years old, 7 years old, that's who they are. And they may be showing great aptitude for, say, a certain academic field, or, great intelligence or creativity or leadership that is exceptional. But this child, that's one aspect. They have developmental needs. They have emotional needs. They have needs with their physical development that ought to go in tandem with their being, whom they are. So emotionally, most of these children would not be well prepared and cannot be, to handle all that fame, all that attention, all that sometimes wealth that comes with it. And you're barely 6, 7 years old. You don't have the mental infrastructure, the emotional infrastructure to accommodate this.
Looks nice, eh?
5-year-old Elias Muthomi, like many other children, is different. The gaps lie in the lack of programs and assessment tools for identifying and nurturing these gifts and talents.
I will clap and do something. Self. Let's do self.